Okay, in this short video, what we're going to take a look at is information from our Foresight GC3. So this is a series on how we can use technology to improve our practice sessions and to get proper feedback. So we're going to look at a shot here. We'll call this a slice, or, well, this particular shot isn't quite a slice. This is more of a fade. But for a right-handed player, a ball that is going to be moving from left to right, and how to use the data that's presented or given to us from the GC3. How to interpret it, and how we can then have some practice activities that can help us work on these things so we can make some adjustments to our ball flight. So we'll just take a look at this particular shot here. So this is a shot from a player that has a right-handed player that has a curve with the ball starting left and then going to the right. And we'll just take a look at some of these numbers. So if you're practicing and this is a pattern of shot that you struggle with, a ball slicing too much to the right or moving too much to the right, you can then take a look at some of these data points down here at the bottom, these tiles that are here, and we'll just kind of go through a few of these and talk about them and what they mean and how you can then practice or structure your practice to work on these things so you're able to actually change them and create a ball flight that you want, that's effective for you. So down here, if we start with this first tile over here on the left, this is launch direction. So for our sakes here with the GC3 launch monitor, it has three high-speed cameras in it, and you've got one that's focused on the golf club and two are focused on the golf ball. So launch direction, even though it's not exactly measuring the club face, when you're using an iron, and let's assume for all these shots that the ball was hit relatively solid and pretty close to the center of the face, we can make this assumption that launch direction is where the club face is pointed. So for this particular shot, this data point here at the bottom left is telling us that that ball took off at 4.9 degrees left from its stationary position. So let's just call that the club face. So our club face at impact was pointed 4.9 degrees to the left. The next tile over, this is letting us know the direction our club was traveling at impact. So that's referred to as our club path. And this was 7.4 degrees. And the O to I here stands for out to in. So for a right-handed player, again, this would be a club that would move from outside the target line to inside the target line. So the club would be swinging to the left through impact, 7.4 degrees, and we have a club face that is pointed left at impact, 4.9 degrees. So both of these are to the left, but the golf ball is tilted here and coming back and spinning back to the right. So our next two tiles, the ones here in the middle, we have our spin axis tilt and our side spin. They're both representing the same thing, just in a different way. So just which way the golf ball is moving. So anytime we strike a golf ball, again, assuming it's relatively solid and in the center, if our club face is more to the right than the path for a right-handed player, this ball is going to get tilted on its axis to the right. So I like to picture like airplane wings there. So imagine an airplane flying through the air with its wings tilted to the right. That's what's going to make this golf ball turn off to the right. And then the side spin is just a measurement, a different way to measure that same information. So this is showing 1623 to the right. So this is in RPMs. The higher this number, the more this ball is going to be curving to the right. And same with your spin axis tilt. The higher that number in degrees, the more the ball is going to turn to the right. The way those two numbers would increase would be having, go back to our first and second tile, the launch direction and the path, the further those two numbers are apart. So since both of these are to the left, 4.9 and 7.4, we've got a face and a path that are differing by 2.5 degrees. So as an example, if this launch direction here was zero, then we'd have 7.4 degrees of difference. So that's a higher number. That would create higher tilt. So imagine banking those airplanes' wings even more, and this spin rate would go up as well, which would then bring us to our fifth tile here, which is curve. This particular shot curved 12 yards to the right. So any increase in these numbers, any increase in how far apart the face and path are, would then increase the curve as well. So this ball would have curved even more. Now this just happens to be a pretty effective ball flight to the right, which is important to know, because a lot of people might see this path and think, well, that's bad. It's out to in, sort of out to in path can have a bit of a taboo to it. People think this is over the top. But as long as you get a club face that can match this or works well with this path, you can still create a very effective ball flight. So this golf ball did curve 12 yards, but it only finished 2.2 yards offline. So the ball starts to the left, which we see over here at the first tile launch direction. Because this club face is still right of the path, it's not as far left as the path, the ball gets tilted on its axis. So here's our 12.5 tilt, or our 16.23 spin, which is creating 12 yards of curve, which just has the ball finish 2.2 yards. This is actually going to be to the right. So since it's a positive number, this would be 2.2 yards to the right of our target. If this was a negative, that would just represent being to the left. So this is how, these are going to be the important numbers you're going to want to look for if you're working on controlling your ball flight. So you're going to want to be able to control your launch direction. You're going to want to be able to control, to a certain extent, your path, which would then have you control, which would, that way you're now controlling the tilt or the spin that you're putting on the golf ball, which would in effect control the curve, which would in effect control how close you are to actually hitting your target. So hopefully that helps. I'm going to keep creating some of these videos with a bunch of different ball flights, some with more curve, different heights, and we'll just keep going through these different scenarios so you can get a good understanding on how you can use technology to really practice effectively. So I will put in the comments, I guess, of this video, depending on where you're watching it, I'll put it in the comments, or at least put some links to videos that I've created that will help you now then work on, so activities that you can do that'll help you gain control of the club face, and activities you can do that can help you understand and control your path better. So the more skilled you get at those two things, the more skilled you're going to be at controlling your ball flight. Thank you.